Hello, friends. Hope you and your family are doing well. Let us share some recent updates with you. It's now well known that in coming years, the bankable market of national security satellites in the U.S. are going to be dominated by mainly two companies, Elon Musk's SpaceX and Boeing-Lockheed Martin joint venture United Launch Alliance. They're making billions, beating out Blue Origin and Northrop Grumman in fierce competition. If we go back 6 years and take a look at the national security satellites market in the U.S., Elon Musk's SpaceX was just a startup, aspiring to break United Launch Alliance's exclusive control over the market. Now, it's part of the establishment. On August 7th, Friday, when the U.S. Air Force announced that SpaceX and ULA would share the National Security Space Launch, NSSL, Phase 2 contracts for launches between 2022 and 2027, it made sure that SpaceX is going to make a big impact on government launch market. United Launch Alliance has won 60% of the launches using its next-generation Vulcan rocket, while Elon Musk's SpaceX has won the remaining 40% using its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. The Air Force's acquisition chief, Will Roper, has said it expects to spend about $1 billion per year on launches. The initial contracts are for launch service orders beginning in 2022 and allocate $337 million to ULA for two classified missions, USSF 51 and USSF 106, whereas SpaceX bags $316 million for mission USSF 67, roughly 34 in total that the two rocket forms will support through 2027. Military officials did not say exactly how many launches that might include, nor did they provide the total contract amount. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss how SpaceX won this landmark multi-billion dollar launch agreements with the Pentagon. Let's get into details. Stay tuned. Six years back, in 2014, ULA had complete dominance over national security satellites market as the only producer of certified heavy lift rockets for military use. Infuriated with the Air Force's award of block buy contract to ULA for Atlas V and Delta IV rockets, the newcomer, SpaceX, filed a lawsuit in federal court. They presented their argument, willing to contend for some of those launches. The Air Force countered that SpaceX's Falcon 9 vehicle was not certified and thus could not compete. In 2015, SpaceX got some privilege from Air Force to speed up the approval process of certifying their Falcon 9 rockets to contend for further contracts. Hence, they decided to drop the lawsuit. Since then, Elon Musk's company has won several contracts, which include GPS 30 satellite as well. In the meantime, the surly relationship between Russia and the U.S. made a huge impact on the national security launch market. U.S. had a long-term dependency on Russian-built RD-180 engine used for Atlas V. When Russia threatened the U.S. to stop exporting those engines in response to Western sanctions, the process to wind up Russian dependency started accelerating. In October 2018, SpaceX was excluded again, and Air Force awarded launch service agreements contracts to ULA, Northrop Grumman, and Blue Origin to support the development of their rockets. These funds were intended to help the companies make competitive bids for the mid-2020s launch contracts. Now, interestingly, on Friday, the announcement of National Security Space Launch Phase 2 contracts gave a clear indication that the decade-long dominance of ULA is going to end, and SpaceX is going to play a key role from now on. Let us take a quick look at ULA's story as well. United Launch Alliance may have fought SpaceX better when they tried to get into a market where ULA had complete possession. Under the leadership of Tory Bruno, president and chief executive of the company from 2014, ULA has adapted well to the changing market. They've invested a hefty amount in the last few years working on next-generation rockets. On Friday, Bruno said in a statement, ULA is honored to be selected as one of two launch providers in this procurement. He added that Vulcan Centaur provides higher performance and greater affordability while continuing to deliver our unmatched reliability and orbital precision well into the future. Vulcan Centaur, a partially reusable new rocket from ULA, will eventually replace the other ones, Atlas V and Delta IV, reducing dependency on the RD-180. This new rocket also includes high-power BE-4 methane oxygen engine in its first stage and hydrogen-burning Aerojet Rocketdyne Centaur upper stage engine, which used to be a Blue Origins feature earlier. Although this rocket may make its debut in 2021, that's not certain, as technical problems almost invariably crop up during the development of new launch systems. Will Roper, the Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology, and Logistics, said that ULA will continue to use Atlas V until Vulcan is ready due to the congressional law, which restricts the purchase of new engines which are available in dozens. As a long runner in national security launch market, ULA was anyway a front runner, and Bruno was confident that their experience would curb any uncertainty regarding the new launch vehicle. Now it's time to focus on SpaceX's story. To take a leap on this business, SpaceX has also been eyeing for a remarkable upgrade for the Phase 2 missions. They're going to construct a new movable gantry pad, 39A, at NASA's Kennedy Space Center. The military requirement to vertically integrate sensitive top-secret spy satellites will be fulfilled by a mobile tower on the north side of the pad's launch mount. Gwynne Shotwell, the President and Chief Operating Officer of SpaceX, said at Satellite 2020, "We fought hard to enter this market, and we really hope we can continue. We've done a good job building a launch vehicle that can serve many markets." She's responsible for SpaceX's day-to-day operations and company growth. As of 2020, she's listed as the 55th most powerful woman in the world by Forbes. The two losing companies, Blue Origin and Northrop Grumman, have different stories. Blue Origin's development of New Glenn at an estimated cost of $2.5 billion has been funded by Jeff Bezos, the founder of the company. He's invested from his massive wealth from Amazon.com to fulfill his long-term vision of millions of people staying and working in space. Losing a single contract is definitely not going to derail Jeff Bezos' dream as they continue to work on both the New Glenn rocket and a launch complex at Cape Canaveral. They're also still involved in the NSSL Phase 2 program as a supplier to ULA. One of the first stage of ULA's Vulcan and Blue Origin's New Glenn rocket, the BE-4 engine, is going to be used. As per their CEO, Bob Smith's statement, "It was disappointing to be left out, but Blue Origin will continue to develop its New Glenn rocket to fulfill their other contracts and also are looking forward to supporting ULA's future role." Northrop Grumman also said in a statement that it was disappointed by the outcome. But is this all about what we witnessed on Friday? No, my friends, there is a story which we will keep an eye on. SpaceX's rockets are usually priced at a fraction of the cost of ULA's, but it was not clear at all why the value of the contract awarded to SpaceX was far higher than ULA's per launch price. SpaceX's contract also put the price of one of its missions at more than three times the $90 million sticker price of its Falcon Heavy rocket. Air Force's Assistant Secretary for Acquisition, Will Roper, refrained from making any comments on Friday, citing the confidentiality of the mission. But Roper added that the budget they've been spending over the years may come down, and they've already saved $7 billion since 2013. He also added, saying, "This is a groundbreaking day, culminating years of strategic planning and effort by the Department of the Air Force, NRO, and our launch service industry partners. Maintaining a competitive launch market, servicing both government and commercial customers, is how we encourage continued innovation and assured access to space." It was an astounding week for SpaceX, not only for winning the contracts, but also for making the first piloted American flight to orbit. In 2011, the space shuttle was retired safely and brought two NASA astronauts back after a 64-day test. After 2 days, SpaceX has successfully launched a prototype from Boca Chica, Texas facility. It was a planned Starship rocket on an up-down test. Their Falcon 9 rocket has already launched 57 Starlink satellites and two remote sensing microstats into the orbit from Kennedy Space Center last Friday. That's all for today, and we'll come back soon with more information and more unanswered questions. Till then, goodbye, stay home, and stay safe. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.